Here we are going to discuss ship's magnetism. The ship's magnetism is of two types on the ship. One is permanent and one is induced. Induced, that will be temporary. As the time passes, the induced magnetism can be demagnetized. Here, the magnetism, induced magnetism as well as permanent magnetism are up generally in the three directions. One is in forward and aft direction. Second one is in the outward ship. And the third one is in vertical. I have made some diagram, the side view and the top view, such that we can see easily and we can understand what is forward and aft, permanent magnetism and induced magnetism, what is vertical permanent magnetism and induced magnetism, and then the vertical or vertical direction, permanent magnetism as well as the induced magnetism. Here the red line that will depict and it will give some picture to understand the magnetism. The earth magnetism, here we have made some examples like earth south pole and earth north pole. The magnetic lines is originating from the earth south pole, that is from the red one, and entering in the north pole, that is the blue one. With that we have made some examples like the ships have different courses, like A has a different courses like in northerly directions, B has the course of southerly direction, and the C has the course of northeasterly direction. So how the ship's magnetism, like the induced magnetism, they have generated in such a way that they are making a dipole. The earth is the earth magnetism or any magnetism, like we have taken an example, like we have the L shape of the magnetism, we have broken into two part, one part has become L by 2 and another part has become L by 2, but still they are representing as a dipole. Dipole means there is a two pole, blue and the red. Like the earth has the also the same, they have made a two pole, that is an induced pole. The A has made in the forward direction red pole, and the aft direction A, ships A has made a, in the aft a blue pole. Like the B in the forward direction, the ship B has made a blue pole, and in the aft direction it has made the red pole. Now if you take the C ships, the example is the C ships, the stern part around the starboard quarter we have made the blue pole, and in the other side it has made the red pole. In this ship's magnetism there are two different of component. One is the horizontal component and one is the vertical component. The horizontal component is designated as the H and the vertical component is designated as the Z. When we add, it will give a the total of the H and Z component. We have taken the right side, we have taken some formula, like the horizontal component is equal to T into cos dip, and the vertical component Z is the T sin dip, and the tan dip is Z by H. Here the H is the horizontal component, that will remains horizontal. Z can be upward and can be or downward depending upon the northern hemisphere or the southern hemisphere. The dip is the angle between the total magnetic component divide and the horizontal component. Here we have taken some examples like the earth's north pole and the earth's south pole. When the ship's needle, like the ship's magnetic compass, is in the magnetic north or in the northern hemisphere, extreme north, like at a latitude of 90 degree, what will be the behavior of the magnetic compass? In that case, the magnetic needle, the forward part is the red one and the aft part is the blue one. In that case, the red part will point directly downward to the magnetic north, that is the earth's north pole, with the magnetic north pole. At that time, the magnetic compass needle that will point downward, that is the red color. Like the same, if the ship is in the earth's south pole, magnetic pole, in that case, the blue one, like the aft one, that will be completely behind the downward. On ship, there are 9 imaginary rods. If you talk about the ship's structure, actually it is a ship structure only, but it is divided into 9 rods. The rod naming is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and K. I is not here, but the rod, the ship's structure, that is divided into 9 rods. The forward and aft rods is consist of A, D, G, earthworship rod is divided in PEH and the vertical rod is CFNK. Actually, the A rod is forward and aft. D is forward and aft rod. G is also forward and aft rod. The forward and aft rod is such a way that maybe the one rod is running from the aft to forward in a continuous way. One, it can be passed through the center line, and the other can be away from the center line but in the forward and aft direction. Maybe other thing is it is divided into two part but in the forward and aft direction. The same like the earthworship direction and the vertical direction. Here the shift magnetism, we will discuss the forward and aft rod. Rules for the nine rods like the imaginary soft iron rods. We will discuss here forward and aft rods. A, D and G. The A has two component plus A minus A. D has two component plus T and minus T. And the G has two component plus G and minus G. We have made a top view and the side view, like top view for the A and the top view for the D rod and the side view for the G rod. Before going to discuss the rod, we have the three most important points that will act as the pillar for the magnetism. Here the reference point is that when the rod is induced, it will be a dipole, like one may be a red pole and the one is the blue pole. The second point is the forward of the compass and the starboard side of the compass, and below the compass that rod will be the positive pole, and the aft of the compass, port side of the compass, and above the compass that will act as a negative pole. Here below 7 point I have made one example of 1 and 2 and the dot representing the compass. The 1 is saying forward, means it is positive, and the port side it is negative, so positive negative makes negative. Now the second option is forward is positive and the starboard side is positive, so positive positive is positive. Earthworship rod is the B rod, E rod and the H rod. The B rod has two component plus B and minus B. The E rod has two component of plus E and minus E, and the H rod has two component of plus H and minus H. Here we have taken the top view of the B rod, of the B rod and the E rod, and the aft view of the H rod. Again here the reference point is very important regarding the rod induced, so it will be a red pole and a blue pole because it will become a dipole. Again the forward of the compass, that is the again the starboard side of the compass, and below the compass the pole that will be taken as a positive pole, and aft of the compass, port side of the compass, and above the compass that will be taken as a negative pole. So accordingly we have marked the dot representing the compass. So the plus B rod, minus B rod, plus E rod, minus E rod, plus H rod and minus H rod. Here the vertical rod is the C rod, F rod and the K rod. C rod has two component of plus C and minus C. F rod has two component of plus F and minus F. K rod has two component of plus K and minus K. We are taking the example in such a way that it will be looks like a side view and the stern view. The reference point, that is we have already discussed, but it is important here because when the rod is induced, it will be a red pole or it will be a blue pole, so it will be a dipole. And the forward of the compass, starboard side of the compass and below the compass, that will be a positive pole, and after the compass, port side of the compass and above the compass, that will be a negative pole. So accordingly the C rod, minus C rod, plus F rod, minus F rod, plus K rod, minus K rod has made in such a way, so it will be give us such information, and it is the base of the magnetism. After that the component we will discuss, so it is very important to know the rod of the ships. Actually ship is the structure, so it is divided on nine rods that elect a very vital play. Coefficient A is caused by induced magnetism in unsymmetrical pairs of horizontal soft iron around the compass. We have already discussed there are 9 rods in the direction of forward and aft, in the direction of earthworship and in the direction of vertical directions. So here the A is the coefficient where it has the two component, like the plus A and the minus A. The plus A coefficient is caused by minus B rod or plus D rod, and the minus A coefficient is caused by plus B rod and minus D rod, which easily we can understand that there is a plus minus sign in between B and D rod. Both are caused for the coefficient of A. We have taken as a top view, like the coefficient A, which will be the Sturley deviation on all heading, and coefficient like minus A is the Sturley deviation on all heading. And when we make the like diagram deviation card, so the Sturley deviation and the Sturley deviation, that is the constant, the line is constant and it is not a curve like a sinusoidal curve or the cosine curve. So the plus A and the minus A is very easily understood by the reference point that is in the forward direction. Like forward direction, the rod is positive, and the starboard side the rod is positive of the compass, and below the rod is there, then it is a positive. And the negative one is when it is in the port side or above the compass or after the compass, it is a negative side. So accordingly, the minus B plus D rod makes a plus A coefficient, plus B rod minus D rod makes a minus A coefficient. Here the ship's magnetism, we will discuss the coefficient B. The coefficient B is a two type, one is the permanent and one is the induced. Here we will more focus on permanent B, that is the plus B. We have the two permanent B, one is a plus B and one is minus B. Here we will discuss only the plus B. Before going, we will go in the second point here. During the ship building, like when the keel plate is laid up, suppose the course at that time is 180, and because of the Earth's magnetism, like the South Pole and the North Pole, the magnetic lines are originating from the South Pole and meeting towards North Pole, that is the blue one. Because of ship's magnetism, the ship is magnetized, permanently magnetized, because the ship is made in 6 months, maybe in 12 months, so because of the long exposure. So in the bow, blue pole will be developed, and in the stern, red pole will be developed. So in the figure one, we will see as a side view. The stern is the red one and the bow is the blue one, and we have made the compass. So the magnetic lines will pass from the stern to forward one, that is the plus B. Suppose it is a minus B permanent, so what happened? The blue will be the stern and the red will be in the forward. So here we are talking of plus B only. Here in the ship's magnetism coefficient B, we will discuss here minus B. Before discussing minus B, we will go in the point number two. Here, during the ship building, due to long exposure, permanent magnetism induced due to earth magnetism. Why? Because here the keel lead course is 000, and due to a long exposure, maybe of 6 months, 12 months, because of the earth magnetism, the dipole has developed in the bow side, the red one, and the stern side, the blue one. Now in the point one, we will see a side view. The forward one is the red and the aft one is the blue pole. Now the magnetic lines will always originate from the south pole to north pole, that is from the red one to the blue one. So here the side view, because here this the magnetic lines which are going forward to aft or aft to forward depending upon plus B and minus B. Here the force P is responsible, that is the forward and aft horizontal component is responsible here. Here we will discuss the induced B. Induced B is also of the two type. One is the plus IB and one is the minus IB. Here we will discuss minus IB, means the induced B, which is a minus sign. Here when the ship is in the northern hemisphere, and because of the magnetism north pole, the blue pole will be developed in the engine room casing at the top. So the dipole moment will be created, dipole will be formed,
and in the down, the reticle will be formed. The blue pole developed as the engine casing in the northern hemisphere, and if you go in the southern hemisphere, so it will be a plus IB. So it will be very confusing, so we will see later. Here we will focus only on the minus IB. So the engine casing will be the induced magnetism, where the top one is the blue pole and the down is the red pole. Now the magnetic lines originate from the red pole to blue pole, that is from the south pole to north pole. So here the magnetism at the magnetic compass, that will induce magnetism, that will affect something. So we will see in the next slide the plus IB. Here the SIPS magnetism B, which we will discuss here, the induced one which is of the plus B type, like plus IB, that is the induced one. When the SIP is in the southern hemisphere, the engine arm casing at the top will develop a red pole, and in the down it will develop a blue pole. And this is happening because of the C rod is a vertical type rod, and the magnetic lines which will pass from top of the engine casing to the downward rod, which is affecting the compass. Here we will discuss the coefficient C. The coefficient C is of two types. One is permanent C and other is IC, like induced C. The permanent C we can also denote as a PC. So we will take the case here when the SIP building is 090, like the keel lead initially 090, and for the SIP building it takes around 10 months, 6 months or 12 months during that period. Because of the earth magnetism, the permanent magnetism induced because of the keel or the longitudinal plates or by the earth worship plates. So the permanent C is caused mainly because of the horizontal earth worship component. Any rod which is in the earth worship direction continuously, so magnetism will be induced, which is also called the force Q. So here, because of the keel lead is 090, so it is the PC, like a permanent C. The pole which is induced in the SIPS magnetism, like in the port side, the red pole has come, and the starboard side, the blue pole has induced because of the earth magnetism. So what will happen? From the red pole, the magnetic lines originate, and in the blue pole, magnetic lines enter into it, that is towards. So the magnetic field is acting towards the starboard side, so that's why it is the PC. Another case we are discussing here, like the keel lead is, if it is 270 degree, the 270 degree, because of the earth's magnetism, the port side has become the blue one and the starboard side has become the red one. So it is minus PC, and the earth, because of the earth magnetism, induced magnetism will generate a magnetic lines, like it will originate from the red pole and it will enter in the blue pole. Like here in the minus PC, the starboard side become the red pole and the port side become the blue pole. So the magnetic lines will enter into the port side. Induced C of the SIPS magnetism is caused by vertical rod, that is the F rod. The F rod comes under the vertical rods, and the IC does not exist for the merchant ships because of the symmetry of the vessel, like port side and the starboard side both are symmetry. So the IC does not exist for the merchant ships, but the IC exists for the aircraft carrier, because one side is accommodation, other side is for the runway. So the magnetic compass is shifted to the one side. So the symmetry is not present here in the aircraft carrier. That's why IC exists on the aircraft carrier, but not in the merchant ships. Coefficient D is caused by the soft iron in the forward and aft direction, as well in the earth worship direction, induced by the horizontal forces of the earth. When the ship is building, by the girders as well as the beams, like in the longitudinal direction as well as in the earth worship direction. So the coefficient D is caused by combining both the horizontal as well as the earth worship beams as well as the girder. So for the plus D,
the rod which are responsible is minus E rod and the plus A rod. The plus A rod is the rod which is divided into two parts from the compass, like forward of the compass and one is the after the compass. And the minus E is the continuous rod in the earthworship direction. And for the minus D coefficient, the plus E is responsible, which is in the earthworship direction, break into two part. Minus A rod, which is moving in the longitudinal direction, and it is continuous. So because of the earth magnetism, these rods are magnetized and are called as a constituent coefficient D, which of the two type, plus D and the minus D.
Coefficient E is caused by the horizontal field at the compass position due to induced magnetism in the horizontal soft iron situated symmetrically about a 45 degree line through the compass position. We have made the examples of plus E and minus E because the coefficient E has the two coefficient, plus E coefficient and minus E coefficient. Plus E coefficient, if you see, it is of the two type. One is the continuous rod and one is the at 45 degree it is divided one. And the minus E again is same, is a one is the continuous rod and one is the divided one. Both are at a 45 degree. So the line which are or the metal or the soft iron which is continuously running in the 45 degree angle or in the break part at a 45 degree angle, so they are constituting E or minus E. Here we will see the corrector magnet, like in the forward and aft direction, and the second one is in the fender bar, and the third one is in the earthworship direction. Now the correction for the forward and aft, the permanent magnetism, which is originating from the stern part, that is the red pole, and coming towards the blue pole, that is in the forward one. So the magnetic lines that will affect the magnetic compass, to correct it, we have placed the forward and aft magnetic corrector in the magnetic compass binnacle in such a way that it will counteract the permanent magnetism of the ships. Like again the printer bar that is used to correct the induced B means the magnetism that has induced because of the vertically. So here the stern part, like the engine room casing, the top one is the blue one and the down one is the red one. So to compensate it, so the fender bar is blue and the down one is the red one, which is forward of the compass, so it will compensate the induced V. Like that we have the earthworship. During the ship building, maybe it will take 6 months to 12 months for ship building. In the earthworship direction, the permanent magnetism has created. So to compensate it, so in the compass section in the Monkey Island, so it's in the earthworship direction, one magnet is kept, so that will correct the permanent magnetism of the earthworship direction. So it will be the correction of earthworship magnet. The fourth type of the correcting magnet is the vertical soft iron, that is a spare one. It is correcting the D. So in the merchant ships normally there is a plus D because the transverse beams is more than the forward and aft continuous girdle. So in the diagram we can see the red one, that is a red sphere, and the blue sphere that is partly divided, conducting from the magnetic lines, conducting from originating from the red pole and going to the blue pole. Now in the ships, the horizontal strips which is made is the red one and the blue one. So the magnetic lines is originating from the red and entering in the blue, so it is contracting the both. So the vertical soft iron, that is the sphere one, is correcting the D. The total deviation is equal to delta is equal to A plus B sine cos plus C cos cos plus D sine 2 cos plus E cos 2 cos. Here the A, B, C, D, E are the coefficient. So the total deviation is the delta is equal to the formula that we have written. Now I have made some graph in such a way, taking as a positive only, I have not made the negative one, so it will be other way around.
like the A steady deviation, when it will be minus 1, minus A, it will go to west side. Like the plus B, like plus C, plus D, plus E, it is nothing but it is depending upon the course, how the ship's course and what will be the deviation. So it's a deviation curve. A healing error is the difference in deviation between that when the ship is upright and when healed on the same course. As an example, the deviation when the ship is upright is 6 degrees east, and when there is a heel, the ship is heeled to any one side, either port side or starboard side, at that time the deviation is 8 degrees east. So because of the heel, deviation has increased, so the healing error here is 2 degrees east. Magnetic field acts as an oblique angle, where the horizontal component of this oblique angle causes a deviation. Healing error is generally caused by two types. One is permanent healing error and the second one is induced healing error. In the permanent healing error, the vertical rod, which are the fixed one, at the time of shipbuilding, where it is magnetized, it is called a force R. It is responsible for the permanent healing error. Whereas the induced healing error is responsible by K rod, E rod, G rod and C rod. Healing error is caused by permanent healing error as well as the induced healing error. In the permanent healing error, the vertical soft iron is responsible for the permanent healing error, where during the ship building, the ship was built around in the 6 months or in the 12 months. So the vertical rod are got magnetized. So it is giving a responsibility that the vertical magnet is responsible for the permanent healing error. The Z component is a vertical component that is applicable. But in the induced healing error, where are the responsible rods are the K rod, E rod, G rod, C rod, that in the earlier video, maybe we have seen that there are 9 important rods which are the imaginary rods. So in the K rod, there is a vertical soft iron which is magnetized, and the Z is responsible, like the vertical component is responsible. In the E rod or thwartship, soft iron magnetizes, which is responsible as a Z rod. G rod is the forward and aft soft iron magnetized, where H is the horizontal component. C rod is the vertical soft iron, where H magnetizes.